Chad Michael Grimsley. Psalms 139 states, "You saw me before I was born. Every day of my life was recorded in your book. Every moment was laid out. God knew before we entered this earth that he was preparing us to meet each other." Marriage is very sacred, and God did not mess up along the way. Our trials brought wisdom to grow and change in order for our relationship to prosper. Jeremiah 17:9 tells us the human heart is the most deceitful of all things, and that we shouldn't follow it or our emotions because that is our flesh. Showing wisdom by watching someone's character and actions are what should be looked at when finding a life partner. Time and time again, you have showed your loyalty, kindness, strength, faith, accountability, and so much more. You have never let me down, and you are literally a man of your word. I promise to show you the same throughout our lives. I promise to love you unconditionally, even on the tough days. I vow to honor our relationship, be patient, speak my mind, and always work on folding the socks. I promise to walk beside you no matter what life brings us, and I promise to show you the unconditional love you have always shown me. I can't wait to grow family with you and continue to see what God has already planned out for our future. I love you.
Enough for me to feel like I am close enough to you. You wear white and I wear out the words I love you, and you're beautiful. Now that the wait is over, love has finally showed her my way. All the music dies.
rise.
Her day starts with a coffee and ends with a wine. Takes forever in getting ready, so she's never on time for anything. When she gets that come get me look in her eyes, well, it kinda scares me the way that she drives me wild. And she drives me wild. Beautiful, crazy, she can't help but amaze me.
Who gives Stephanie? Who gives Stephanie to be married to Chad?
Her mother and I.
Please be seated. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here together in front of God with family and friends to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony. This union is not to be entered into lightly. This is the most important day of their life. As a little introduction, I just wanted to let each of you know what you're getting into. Stephanie grew up as a tomboy and would always have sweat rings around her neck.
Still does.
She played soccer from the time she was 8 and was devastated when she had to stop playing after high school. She broke her ankle 3 times, and the surgeon said one more time in which she would walk like a duck the rest of her life. She was always a sweet child, but had a bit of a temper. One time, after one of her tantrums, Terry and Gina saw a blanket hanging over her bedroom's window seat.
Oh, God, you're saying this?
You guessed it. She kicked a hole in the drywall when she was angry and covered it up. Good luck, Chad. As far as Chad goes, when he was 4 years old, they went to Disneyland. And all day long, Chad bugged his mother to take him on Space Mountain. She finally gave in and took him on the ride. He hid his face the entire time. Yeah. When they got off, he didn't say a word. So his mom asked him if he had fun. He looked at her and said, "Why would you take a little kid on a ride like that? What were you thinking?" She told him that he was the one that wanted to go on the ride. Chad then said, "You're the parent. You should have known better." Chad played football in high school. During one game in his sophomore year, he made an interception and ran all the way down the field for a touchdown, except he was tackled on the 1 yard line. The worst part is the guy who tackled him was his own teammate. To make matters worse, the teammate was one of his groomsmen, Shane. In Shane's defense, he says he was pushed into him. Right, Shane?
I was.
I had readings prepared, but I asked Steph if she had any requests. She sent me some thoughts, and after reading them, I figured they were too important not to use them. So our blessing today will come from Stephanie's own words.
Oh, you're nervous now, huh?
One way I formed my strong relationship with God was through Scripture. James became one of my 5 favorite apostles as God spoke through him to teach us how to form real, loving relationships. I then realized I previously had it all wrong. James 4-2-3 says, "You are jealous of what others have, yet you don't have what you want because you don't ask God for it. And even when you ask, you don't get it because your motives are all wrong. You want only what gives you pleasure." I felt James was speaking to me. All I prayed for was to find a husband. My motives were all wrong. I had a selfish desire to fill the hole within it with another man instead of filling my heart with the Lord's love. God showed me how to love myself through knowing Him. James taught me how to love myself by loving others in an authentic way. James also taught me to turn away from greediness, jealousy, and pride, but instead turn to serving others any way I could. While God was working through me, one scripture always spoke to my heart when I was really struggling, Isaiah 43. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you go through deep waters, I will be with you. God was with me the entire time. I wouldn't be ready to marry the man of my dreams today if God didn't put me through trials. Through every trial and setback, God was bringing me one step closer to being ready to meet Chad. I would not have been able to have the selfless love God calls on us to have during a relationship without being put through fire. Chad and I started really slow as I made sure he was the man God had for me. Rather than me jumping on the fantasy of having my selfish desires satisfied, which I had fallen into the past, Chad proved to me time and time again that we were made for each other. I hear God speak to me through the words in Esther 4:14, who knows if perhaps you were made queen for just such a time as this? I hear Him telling me that I went through so much hurt and pain to gain wisdom, compassion, selflessness, empathy, optimism, and so much more to prepare for the day I would meet Chad. Now, with one journey ending and a new journey about to begin, I am 100% confident that God has prepared me for just a time as this, a time to deeply love and support my partner, to build a life that is filled with selfless love with a man that will lead and teach our children how to walk with Christ. I have truly been blessed, and I wouldn't want to go through life with anyone else other than man that stands before me today. And now, Chad and Stephanie share their vows.
Just a note, I was going to shoot from the hip on this, but it was strongly recommended I didn't. So, Stephanie, the words "I love you" just doesn't express how much you mean to me. I've heard people talk about finding their other half, their soulmate, and that is what you are to me. You are everything I'm not. You are beautiful inside and out. You open your heart to anyone and everyone and would bend over backwards to help someone in need, even somebody you don't know. The glimmer in your eye and the big smile you make when you enter a room makes you the center of attention. I also don't know if some of this has to do with you being the loudest one in the room at the time. I love you for simply being you. And because of this, I vow to stand by you on your best days, but more importantly on your worst. I vow to pick you up on days where life beats you down, and to celebrate you on days on your big and to celebrate you on your biggest days. I vow to always protect you, love you, guide you, and show you how wonderful you are. Today I become the luckiest man in the world because today I have you.
Chad Michael Grimsley. Psalms 139 states, "You saw me before I was born. Every day of my life was recorded in your book. Every moment was laid out. God knew before we entered this earth that He was preparing us to meet each other." Marriage is very sacred, and God did not mess up along the way. Our trials brought us wisdom to grow and change in order for our relationship to prosper. Jeremiah 17:9 tells us, "The human heart is the most deceitful of all things." And that we shouldn't follow it or our emotions, because that is our flesh. Showing wisdom by watching someone's character and actions are what should be looked at when finding a life partner. Time and time again, you have showed your loyalty, kindness, strength, faith, accountability, and so much more. You have never let me down, and you are literally a man of your word. Literally. I promise to show you the same throughout our lives. I promise to love you unconditionally, even on tough days. I vow to honor a relationship
be patient, speak my mind, and I'll work on folding the socks. I promise to walk beside you no matter what life brings, and I promise to show you the unconditional love you've always shown me. I can't wait to grow family with you and continue to see what God already has planned for our future. I love you.
Love you. Take your hands. Stephanie, repeat after me. I, Stephanie, take thee, Chad.
Do I yell it?
No.
That's just so he can hear you.
I, Stephanie, take thee, Chad.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Chad, repeat after me. I, Chad, take thee, Stephanie.
I, Chad, take thee, Stephanie.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
The wedding ring is an emblem of love through time, a symbol of devotion, and an agreement between a husband and a wife to love and cherish one another for the rest of their days. A ring has no ending, has no beginning and no end, just like the love that you have for each other. May we have the token of Chad's love for Stephanie. Repeat after me. Stephanie, this ring I give.
Stephanie, this ring I give.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
As a sign of my love and devotion.
As a sign of my love and devotion.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
May we have the token of Stephanie's love for Chad. Okay. Chad, this ring I give.
Chad, this ring I give.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
As a sign of my love and devotion.
As a sign of my love and devotion.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed. And I put it on the ring.
Good thing we got the big one.
Everyone, please rise. Lord, please guide and watch over Chad and Stephanie as they start their new journey as husband and wife. Don't ever let them stop trusting in you or each other. I also pray for their families and friends as they pray for and love Stephanie and Chad. And if everybody would please join in saying the Our Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Chad and Stephanie, since you have consented together in holy matrimony and have pledged yourselves to each other by your solemn vows and by the giving of rings, and have declared your commitment of love before God and these witnesses, I now pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Those with whom God has joined together, let no man separate. Chad, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, let me be the first to introduce you to Mr. and Mrs. Chad and Stephanie Grimsley.
at times I almost said what's on my mind, but I didn't. And just the other day I wrote down all the things I'd say, but I couldn't. I just couldn't. Said that I could live this life without you, even though I don't tell you all the time. You had my heart a long, long time ago, in case you didn't know.
And that is The First Dance. Give round of applause.
Song and argument, every word apart. Terrible explosions, fought together wrong. He said, I know, I know, I know the words to. I know, I know the words to. I was there with you, I wrote them too. We said, love is louder than all this. Love is louder than all this. Love is louder than all this noise. We say, love is louder. Your messy heart chosen, but was it overlooked? Are you the crazy in the corner, writing it in your book? Well, and a cynic with a cynic's hook, a certain house got formed. Were you to be taken from me?
And that is the father-daughter dance.
She'll change a dirty diaper, wipe a runny nose, get a two-day purple Kool-Aid stain right out of your clothes. And she'll put her last spare dollar under your pillow when you lose a tooth. She'll bust down your door and drag you out of bed, make you sit right next to her in church, wearing your Sunday best. And when she bows her head to pray, you can bet she's saying one for you.
That was the mother-son dance.
Them for the rest of their lives. And that moment came for Stephanie when she met me 15 years ago. Thank you. Hello everyone and welcome. My name is Kelly. I'm Stephanie's best friend of about 15 years. We met on the soccer field about 15 years ago and have been inseparable ever since. It also helped having a best friend who had super strict parents like mine. We did everything together, like that one time we had broken legs at the same exact time. I'll never forget my dad taking us to the Condors game. We hobbled around the whole arena on our crutches the whole time. We thought we were so cool. Or all the times we used to sneak in my sister's room and try on all her clothes when she wasn't home. She still found out and she hated us, but it's okay.
Sorry, Marcy. Sorry.
We've been there. Hold on. We've been there for each other through some of the hardest times. Through losses and breakups, emotional and mental breakdowns, and a whole lot of hangovers. And I know I wouldn't be the person I am without you. I'm so proud of the person that you've chosen to spend the rest of your life with. Chad. Chad.
Thank you. Thank you.
I honestly couldn't have imagined a better man for my best friend. You two complement each other in the best way, and you two are truly meant for each other. I love you both so much, so if we could please lift our glasses and please say cheers to Mr. and Mrs. Grimsley.
Okay, who's next?
Give her a round of applause.
Get out of here. Where's my shot?
Because he'd choose us. In a hundred lifetimes, he'd
known each other pretty much all of our life.
For as long as I can remember, Chad has been my little brother. Been the absolute best role model for a brother I could ever think of. Has always had my back, no matter what. Didn't matter if I picked a fight, and I absolutely had it coming. He had my back. Stephanie has been in our family's lives for a few years now, and I hate to say it, Chad, but I already like her better than you.
Sorry about it.
Bullshit.
I think everybody here can agree with me that you absolutely bring out the best in Chad, and the best of Chad is yet to come because of you guys. We are very much looking forward to you guys joining or adding to the family. Our little ones playing together, and hopefully Uncle Chad teaching all the little ones all the stuff that they're not supposed to.
When we're ready.
Give us babies.
Yeah, right.
Tonight.
When we're ready.
Tonight.
Stephanie, we love you. Welcome to the family, and let's give a big round of applause and cheers to Mr. and Mrs. Chad.
Hi guys, my name's Corey, one of Chad's best friends. All I can say is, I've been with Chad, we've been best friends like 7th, 8th grade, and a lot of girlfriends through then.
Hey, I'm good looking, alright?
I'm good looking.
It's that ass. So, out of all the girlfriends, never a marriage talk at all. You always, the only thing you ever said was, it would take the right person. And Stephanie, that's you.
Oh, it's your wedding. We have a love hate relationship! This is awesome!
That's all I gotta say. That's all I say. Congratulations to both of you guys. I love you both. Chad, you've always been like a brother. Stephanie.
Thank you.
You're Stephanie.
I'm like a sister.
I'm not saying it. I love you guys. Congratulations.
Chad just said, Jesus Christ.
No!
Chad's just as nervous.
14.
Anyways, a friend of mine wrote a speech for me today that I was supposed to memorize, and I didn't do it because...
It was his daughter's boyfriend.
Yeah, his name's Eric. And I decided just to say something that, from my heart, that I'm so happy that Stephanie met Chad. Chad met Stephanie. And that she's now in our family. And I can't be happier. Thank you to everybody that came here. thank you to Terry and Gina.
Yes.
Terry's going to speak a little bit. Yes. Great job. Awesome place, awesome venue. Congratulations. God bless you all.
Love you, Tracy.
You're here!
No one loves it.
Definitely not.
Welcome.
Okay,
and, we'd like to thank everyone that came, both on behalf of my wife and I, and Chad's family.
Yeah, you're doing good.
Yeah, am I doing good? Okay. I likewise didn't prepare anything, but that doesn't matter. I didn't have anyone to write anything for me like Tracy did.
Yeah.
Stephanie, let's see. When she was a little girl, she liked to play. We were just discussing this, and it popped in my mind. Barbies. She loved Barbies. Matter of fact, we just got rid of all that crap. We said, come and get it.
I still have it all for
you. We're getting married. We don't need it at the house anymore. She used to invite me down the hall to imaginary tea parties. Oh, God. I dreaded going down that hall for her tea and second servings of cookies that were not there. What do you think, Daddy? Oh, I love it. You know, I work graveyards, and I'm tired. And it's like, oh, yeah, I love it. I love it. Next day, she'd call me down again. She even had a little horse, a Barbie horse with a prince on it. Apparently, that's Chad.
Hey, have you ever seen me on a horse?
It's not you. Or you're drunk. And you're backwards.
Yeah, tonight. She went on a horse tonight.
Well, let me, I regress. So that was a milestone. A little, a memory. And you move along.
Hold this together.
You're
doing great.
20 more bucks. You're doing good. 20 more bucks.
Swimming.
You bet on me. Oh, yeah. Hey, that's a sure winner right there. Winner.
That was one milestone. You know, throughout life, you have baptism, you have all the things that go along with life, but they're cherished. And now, looking back, when I'm almost 60, I realize how important this work is. Yeah, it's in you.
And I don't care if no one says that was the best speech of the night. Give him a round of applause. Oh, you guys can do better than that. Okay. Now it's the last man up.
Chad, no pressure, buddy. No. Got a lot of follow-ups to do.
Zero pressure.
I said my vows in front of you. Come on, Steph. Let's go, sir. Thank you. Thank you for everybody that's cried. But in all seriousness, I want to thank everybody that came tonight. We invited people that were closest to us. Be it family, friends, coworkers, whatever it may be. And I know a lot of people traveled a lot of miles. We really appreciate that, especially with this whole COVID thing. Everybody that's here tonight, from the bottom of our hearts, we appreciate it.
Yeah? I just sniffled.
Oh, you're okay?
I'm trying to hold it together.
I'm trying to make somebody, I want to win $20 more, so I'm trying to make her cry one more time. But honestly, everybody raise your glasses in the air real quick.
Ayo.
Just real quick. No.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I'll take mine. You leave yours right there. You leave yours right there. No, you leave yours. This wedding would not be possible without my beautiful bride. She put in time and work and extra hours. And an extreme amount of pressure on her with work. COVID, family, everybody just pressing down on her, and she persevered. So this is to you, babe.
You really wanted those extra $20? Thank you so
much. One more time, let's hear it for the bride. Cheers.
Let's party.
It's alright.